Hey everybody, this is the Computer Geek 01010101 here, and today is October 10th, 2018. Yep, 10-10. And today I'm going to be cleaning my dad's main computer, which is a Gateway FX6380. This machine has not been cleaned since March of this year. Just like my main computer, up until Sunday the 8th of this year. Anyways, this machine has ran almost nonstop for about 6 months. And this chair needs to get out of my way. There, that's better. Anyways, yeah. So this thing operates in a dusty environment, our living room, and yeah. So, this machine originally had an ATI Radeon HD 5050 graphics card installed, but that graphics card went buggy, and there's currently an EVGA something or other, I forgot the model number, an EVGA 980 Ti Superclocked, I believe, installed in here. So let's go ahead and pop this out of the machine for the first time in 6 months. And already we see some signs of dust. We have dust floating in the air. We also have dust here. We have quite a bit of dust on the, top. High. Of course, it's showing up completely backwards on the camera. We have a Western Digital Black hard drive in here, which runs extremely hot. We also have a Microsoft Windows 7 product key, which good luck deciphering that with his grainy as frick video. Not really, but good luck deciphering it. Another couple case screws here, and we should start tearing into this machine very shortly. And we also have dust on this side of the case, on this case panel. Especially right there for some odd reason. Anyways, got the hard drive back here. This is all I need access to this side of the case for, is this hard drive. And there's a couple SATA extenders installed in here. For the two front hot swap drive bays. Yep. I've
used those in the past.
A few years ago. Anyways, yeah. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and pull the hard drive caddy out. And that's that. We have a Western Digital Black hard drive in here, as I've already mentioned. I believe it is a 1 TB drive. I'm also going to go ahead and unplug both the optical drives. Yep, we have two in this particular configuration. I'm also going to go ahead and unplug a Mullins power connector. this thing's definitely on the complicated side, but I'm not as complicated as my main computer. Go ahead and disconnect the graphics card from power. And believe me, the GTX 970 super clocked. Yeah. I'm also going to feed these harnesses back through. Kind of just feed everything back through the case so I don't mangle, crush, or amputate anything. And I'm gonna turn the case on its side. Scoot the camera way up and re-angle. Anyways, so the next thing I'm going to do is remove the graphics card from this system. It's as simple as a couple screws. Yes, there is an expansion card retaining device installed on this case. I find it interesting. I'm going to need to get down here and press on this tab without destroying the motherboard, and the graphics card should lift right out as it has just done. And already we can see severe signs of some pretty heavy dust on the car. Now that gives us access to all of our ports and crud way down here, which I'm going to unplug. It's our HDMI audio connector, USB, USB, USB. And then we have a whopping 5 SATA cables. And then we have a case connector thing here. All the SATA cables are connected to something else. I'm going to unplug the 8. First of all, unplug the CPU fan. Next of all, unplug the case fan, and I'm going to go ahead and unplug the 8-pin CPU power connector from the motherboard, and then disconnect the main 12-volt connector from the motherboard, and now the power supply is free to go. The power supply is an FSP Group FSP 750-80APG with an 80 plus standard certification. Features active power factor correction. It says with noise killer, so I guess it has EMI and RFI shielding installed in it, which is nice. And it advertises that it has a ball bearing fan, which I do not doubt at all. Because FSP's offerings are pretty dang robust. I'm going to get these cables out of there. In fact, I might say that they're underrating their power supplies. This unit could probably do 800 watts. Heck, it could probably do 900 watts before it shuts down. But anyways, next thing I'm going to do is this case is going back up. All these cables are coming off the top. This camera is getting re-angled. And this power supply is coming out. Watch a YouTube video compression go absolutely wacko. I'm just gonna hold air supply from the inside so it doesn't go, so it doesn't unexpectedly go kerthunk, which it has not. Power supply gracefully slides back and out of the case. And needs a very thorough, dusting out. The power supply at the back here because we need room up here. Now I'm gonna go ahead and zoom out, and this front panel is coming off. Not completely off, but it is going to be extracted from the front of the machine. I'm also going to take this time to pull the two drive caddies out. But the real reason we need access to, and we need this front thing off, is we need to remove the optical drives from this machine. Okay, come on. Okay. Drive one is out. It is a DVD rewritable drive model DH-16AASH-15B. Pulls an amp and a half on both the 5 and 12 volt rails. I assume that's whenever there's actually a disc inserted. And there's some screws on the other side that I'm going to need to extract. Or maybe the drive is not wanting to come out. Which, that's easily fixable. Just like that. This drive is a Blu-ray disc combo drive. Model DH-6E2S23C. Manufactured February 27th, 2010. The other drive was manufactured March 6th of 2010. Put those on top of the hard drive. Get all these screws out of the way. To temporarily reinstall the front panel. There we go. Now, pull the computer forward again. Let's go ahead and pull the motherboard out. This is already going a million times faster than my main computer cleaning. Mainly because A, the case isn't so freaking loaded with components. And B, there's not so many freaking things in here. This machine has 16 gigabytes of RAM installed, spread across four gigabyte sticks. And I forgot a screw. And I forgot another screw. Now, what's this hack job? The way the CPU fan thing hasn't come off its housing, hasn't come off the motherboard. Yep. And it looks like that's all there is to disassembling this machine. Really. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean this machine off camera. And we will return whenever this thing is cleaned. Okay, we're back. Now that I have cleaned everything, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to reinstall the motherboard. After we get everything out from under it, of course. Alrighty. Alrighty. Next thing to go back in are the optical drives. I was going to have to take the front of the case off of that. Thank you. Well, that's that reinstalled. Alrighty, I gotta go ahead and plug the 4.5 billion cables back into the motherboard. Alrighty, that's that done. All that done. Kind of. I somehow managed to expertly loop the SATA cable through one of the, between two of the wires on this connector. Twice in a row, which, forget it. Also helps to You ever done that before?
I have.
It's like a son of a gun. Ouch. Why do they have to make those freaking pins so sharp? I mean, come on, they're connector pins for low current devices. They're not knives or cooking implements or chopping implements or woodworking implements or mowing implements for that matter. Next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and just plop the drive caddy in place. And take a screw. First, I'm gonna accidentally find a screw to the motherboard. And then I'm gonna just go ahead and screw the drive caddy in. I'm going to reinstall the graphics card into this machine. Of course, you're not seeing any of this since I've forgotten to re-angle the camera. Screw that retainer back in. And now it's time to reinstall the power supply into this beast. Put it in here. Slide it in. Next thing I'm going to do is find the SATA cable that's supposed to go to the hard drive and route it accordingly. Okay. I'm going to lower the
camera. And now we're gonna plug up 100,000 cables. Starting with that. Continuing with the optical drive cables. But my arm was blocking up the works. Plug in the CPU 12 volt power connectors. Plug in this heck of a PCIe wiring harness. Wall is fighting entirely too many SATA plugs. Plug this mess up. Turn the case around. Now I'm gonna swing it around to the front and slide our caddies back in. Go and first adjust the camera up in terms of height. And slap a side cover on it. And then once I have the covers on this, we're going to do the usual process of hauling it into the tech room and powering it on. Sure, it is working fine. We'll be back. All right, everybody, we're here in the tech room, got it hooked up. You know, it really does help if you actually plug in the motherboard power connector. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Anyways, power supply is off. Now it's on. Change our KVM switch over to port 4, gateway, delete, enter setup, F12, boot menu. Starting Microsoft Windows 7 Professional. And the machine is working fine. Of course, you know, it helps if Windows has actually installed the drivers for the hardware at hand. Also helps if you don't accidentally kill the power to your KVM switch. Anyways, looks like that's a wrap. Go ahead and shut this thing down. This is the thing I like about PS2. I don't have to wait on Windows to install stinking drivers. It's just a matter of plug it in. And that's it.
That's a wrap.
This is the Computer Geek 01010001001. Peace out, guys. Peace out. See you in the next video. Recording.